Hello everyone, my name is Ashish and welcome to the X-Admin channel. So today in this lecture, I am going to build a user management project using Servlet, JSP, JDBC, MySQL and Tomcat server. So guys, this will be the web project in which I will show you how to write a CRUD operation or how to use a CRUD operation like create, edit, update and delete operation to our MySQL database. Okay. So guys, I am going to write the whole project code step by step, and guys, I believe that this project will help you to understand how to write and use the CRUD operation to your projects. Okay, so guys, let's start the session of the user management project using Servlet, JSP, JDBC, MySQL and a Tomcat server. So first of all, let's go to our Eclipse, and here I am going to create our own project with the name user management. So new, and then we have to create a dynamic web project. So let's provide the name of the project as a user management. All right, and guys, here I'm using Apache Tomcat 8.5 and dynamic web module as 3.1. all right, let's next, and guys, I will generate web.xml and finish. So guys, we have a dynamic web project with the name user management, in which we have a Java resource folder, inside which we have a source folder, and guys, we are going to write all the Java classes inside our source folder, and we have a web content, and inside the web content we have a web inif, and we have a leaf folder. Inside the leaf folder we are going to paste all our libraries file inside this, and guys, we have a web.xml file, and inside the web.xml file we have to write our XMLs configurations. So guys, first of all, I am going to create all the packages which we are going to use in this project. So go to the source, right click source and package. So let's create a package with the name com.xadmin.usermanagement.bean. okay, and let's finish it. And the next package I am going to create as a DAO package. All right, finish. And the next source, right click, package. And the next I am going to create a web package. Okay, so guys, inside the web package I am going to create our servlet file, and inside the DAO package we are going to create a DAO class, and guys, inside the bean package I am going to create a bean class. Okay, so guys let's start with a bean class. So guys, I am going to create a bean class inside the bean package. So class, and guys, I am going to keep the name as a user bean, and guys, inside the user bean there will be the four properties. Okay, and guys, the four properties are like the ID, name, email and the country. So finish it. So guys, I have created the user bean class, and inside this I am going to define the four properties as private, string, name. All right, so let's copy this, and one more I am going to create as a name, email and a country. All right, so guys, now I will create a getter and the setter for the same, and select all fields to create all the getter and setter for all the properties. And now guys, I will create a constructor, like a parametric constructor using fields. So select all fields and then okay. Now guys, I am going to create one more constructor. In this guys, I will exclude ID. Okay, so let's create constructor using field, and now deselect ID and press OK. Okay, so guys, we have a user bean. Inside user bean we have ID, name, email properties and a country property, and we have a setter and a getter method for the same, and we have a constructor, and guys, here the ID will be auto generated ID. All right, So now guys, the next what I am going to do, I am going to create our DAO class. So right click on the DAO package, create on new, and then go to our class and let's provide the class name as a user DAO. So user DAO, alright. So finish this. So guys, I have created the user DAO class, and now guys, inside the DAO class, the first of all I will configure the JDBC driver, and then I will load the driver, and then I will take the connection, and after that guys, I will write all the method to insert the data, to edit the data, to edit the user, to update the user, and to also delete the user, and to select all the user from the database. So guys, I will write all the CRUD operations inside our DAO class. So guys, okay. So guys, before writing the DAO class, okay, I am going to import the libraries. So guys, I am going to import all the jars inside our lib folder. Okay. So guys, let me download the lib folder from the database from the internet. Okay. Yes guys, these are the jars which we have to use in our project. So let's copy all the jar from here and let's paste it inside the lib folder. So guys, you can download all the jars from the internet, or either I will share my the GitHub repository URL, and guys from there you can paste it. Okay, so paste the jar. So guys, inside the lib folder I am using the JSP API 2.2 jar and the GSTL 1.2 jar and the MySQL connector Java 8.0.13 jar for the JDBC, and also a servlet API 2.5 jar for the servlet classes. Okay, so guys, these are the four jars which are required for this application or a project. Okay, so guys, inside the lib folder I have pasted all the jars which are required, and now guys, I am going to write the user DAO class. So guys, the first of all I am going to define all the properties like the JDBC URL and the username, password and the driver name inside the user DAO. Okay, so guys, I am going to write all the JDBC. Okay, so guys, for that I am going to pause the video and I will write, and then I will explain you to save the time. Yes guys, I have written all the JDBC URL, and the JDBC URL is like the JDBC MySQL localhost and the port number, and guys, the default port number is 3306, and guys, my database name is the user DB, and here the use SSR equals to false. Okay, and guys, I have saved the JDBC username inside our JDBC username variable as a root, and the password of the MySQL database is root password given. And guys, the JDBC driver name is com.mysql.jdbc driver. Okay, so guys, these are the configurations of the JDBC. And now guys, I am going to write all the SQL queries, and guys, I am going to store the queries in a variable. So guys, the queries to insert the user to the database, and the queries to select the user according to the ID, and also a query to select all the users to the database, and also a query to delete the user to the database, and also a query to update the user from the database. So guys, let me write the queries and store in a variable, and then I will explain you. Yes guys, I have written all the queries required. So let me minimize this, and guys, here to insert the user, I have written the insert into the users table, and guys, here the users is my table name, and guys, the name, email and the country and the values which will be stored. Okay, and then guys, I have written a query to select the user by ID, and okay, and guys, I have stored in this variable, and the query is select ID, name, email, country from the users table where ID will be, okay, anything. And guys, and this is a query to select all users, select star from users, and to delete the user, delete from users where ID will be anything, and the update user. Guys, update users, and guys, here you have to pass the name, email and the country and where the ID will be, anything. Okay, so guys, still here I have written all the four, and guys, the five SQL queries, and I will store in a variable. So now guys, what I will do, I will create a constructor, a default constructor for this class. So let's go to the source, generate constructor, and then okay. And then guys, I have to remove the auto generated steps. Okay, so guys, I have created a default constructor for now. And now guys, the next step, guys, I am going to write a separate method to get the connection of the JDBC, and guys, inside that method I am going to load the driver also. And after this guys, that method is going to return the connection. Okay, so let's write the method, separate method. So protected connection, get connection. Okay, protected. Okay, and guys, we have to import this connection from the connection dot the java.sql package. All right, so guys, let me write the method first and then I will explain you. So guys, I have written the get connection method, and guys, inside the get connection method I have taken an object as a connection object, and I have declared as a null. And then guys, I am loading the JDBC by the driver name. So guys, already I have assigned this driver name with this variable. So let's make a change here and let's put a name of the variable as a JDBC driver. Okay, and guys, here the try, and guys, inside the try block I am loading the driver as a class dot for name and the driver name. Okay, and after that guys, I am taking the connection, and guys, by using the get connection method of the driver manager class. So guys, we have to import this class with the java.sql. So guys here the driver manager is a class, and guys, we have a get connection method to get the connection, and we have to pass the argument like JDBC URL and the username and the password of my MySQL database. All right, and then guys, inside the catch statement I have written the MySQL exception, so we have to import this also. So import with the java.sql. All right, so guys, and guys, at the last I'm returning the connection object. All right, so guys, the get connection method is to return the connection, and guys, inside this method I have loaded the JDBC, and then I have taken the connection, and then I'm returning the connection. All right, so guys, I have written the get connection method till here. And now guys, the next methods I am going to write are like the CRUD operations method. Okay, so guys, the CRUD operations method, like, let's say guys, insert okay, insert user method. And the next I am going to write a method to select user by ID. Okay, and the next method I am going to write is select all users. Okay, and the method also I am going to create let's say update method, update user method. And the next method is like a delete user from the database. All right, so guys, these are the list of the methods which I am going to create for the update. So guys, let's start with the insert user method. So guys, let's create a method, public void insert user. All right, and guys, inside the insert user I have to take a argument as the user bean class. So user. Okay, so guys, let me import this with the bean package, and guys, let me implement this insert method and then I will explain you. Yes guys, I have written the inset user method implementation, and guys the first I am showing the output is a system.out.println to show in the console. And guys after that I am calling the get connection method to get the connection of the JDBC, and I am storing the connection object. And guys with the help of the connection object I am creating the statement. So guys I am creating the prepared statement object, okay? So connection dot prepared statement, and guys inside the prepared statement I am passing the inset url sql query. So guys inset url, so the inset into the user's name, email, country, all right? And okay, so guys we have to import this prepared statement with the java.sql. And guys after that I am calling a set string method, the set method, to set the name, email and the country to the prepared statement. And after that guys I am passing, or I am calling the execute button, or sorry, the execute update method to run the query to the database to insert the data. All right, so guys here, and guys I am writing a print SQL exception also. So let's create a print SQL exception method to handle all the exceptions which we will get. So guys let me implement this method first. Yes guys, I have implemented the print SQL exception, and guys here you can see that we are running a for loop, and the for each loop we with the ex object of the SQL exception. And guys we are checking the instance. If the instance is of the SQL exception, then guys we have to print all the SQL state error code and the message inside this. And after that guys I am running calling the get cause method to get the cause of the exception, and that is storing in a t object of the throwable type. And then guys I am running a while loop to show the cause of the exception. All right, so guys let me put this method beneath this method at the last. All right, yeah, it's fine. So now guys the next I have to implement is to select user by id. Okay, so let's create method public user select user. And guys inside this I have to pass the argument as a id type. So guys let me implement this method and then I will explain you. So guys I have implemented the select user method, and guys in which I am passing the id to get the user. Okay, and guys here I have created a user object and assigning null. And guys the first step is to stabilize a connection, and guys here I am stabilizing a connection as a get connection. And guys with the help of the get connection object I am creating a prepared statement, okay, connection.prepared statement. And inside this method I am passing the select user by id sql query. So guys this query says that select user by id says that select id, name, email, country from the user table where the id is anything. Okay, so guys it is going to fetch the user information of the particular id. All right, and guys it is going to store in the prepared statement. And after that guys I am setting set int method, and then guys I am executing the query or updating the query by the prepared statement dot execute query. And guys here you can see that we are using the execute update method. And guys here you can see that we are using execute update method because guys here after inserting user it is not going to return anything. But guys in the select user I am using a execute query, and guys this execute query method returns a result set. As you can see that here it is returning a result set. So guys I have been storing the result set and the output or the response of this method to the result set. So we have to import this inside our Java SQL. Okay, after that guys we have to process the result set. It means that guys we have stored the object of the user, so guys we have to process it. And guys for that I am using a while loop rs.next, and then I am taking the name, email and the country from the result set. And guys I'm storing in a variable name, email and a country. And then guys I am passing it inside a constructor, and guys I am passing this to a user bean class. Okay, And guys, after that we are using a catch statement, and then we are returning the user. So guys, if I will call this the select user, then guys it is going to fetch the user as per its ID from the database, and guys it is going to return that user. Okay, so guys, we have implemented the select user method also. Now guys, the next method I am going to implement is a select all user method. It means that guys, if I will call this method, then guys I will get or guys it will return the all the users object present inside our database. All right, so guys, for that let's write a method. So guys, here the return type will be list, because guys here we are taking the all the users. Okay, so guys, we will store the all the users to the list, and then we will return that list. All right, so let's write the method select all users. All right, so guys, let me import this with the java.util package, and let me implement the code, and then I will and guys, I have implemented the select all user method, and guys here the return type is the list. Okay, and guys here in the starting I have created the array list. Okay, and guys here the user will store the array list, and guys first step is to initialize the connection, it will get connection, and then guys the same step I will follow. So let me first import this to the Java util. All right, and then guys here the prepared statement, and here I am passing the select all user, and guys here the query says to select star from users table. So guys, it is going to fetch all the columns from the users table, and then guys I am using the execute query to execute the query. Okay, and then guys it will return a result set, and guys here the result set will be in a list. So guys, here it is going to check rs.next. so guys, it is going to process the result set, and we will get all the name, email, id, and guys here I am creating the user object again and again, and guys I am storing it in a user array list. Okay, so guys I am adding the object of the user to the arrays to the users array list by users.add method, and guys inside the add method I am passing the object of the user, and guys here I am storing the all the name, emails, id, and guys storing in a list, and then guys I am returning it in a list. Okay, so guys I have returned the select all user to fetch all the users and storing in a list, and then returning that list. All right, so next method I am going to implement is to update the user. So guys, the update user will work to update any particular user's name, email, or country name. All right, so let's create the public, and guys here it will be a boolean type to check that whether the update method is executed or not. Update user. All right, and guys we have to update any user by passing the object of the user. All right, So guys, let me write the code, and then I will explain you. So guys, I implemented the update user, and guys here you can see that I have taken a variable of a boolean type as a row updated, and guys first step I am taking the get connection method, and then the second guys I am creating a prepare statement with the help of the connection object, and here I am passing the update SQL query, and guys it says that update users. And guys here you have to set name, email, country, and where the ID is something. Okay, so guys after that I am calling the statement dot set string to set the name, email, and a country, and also the ID. Okay, and guys we have the name and the email and the country we are getting from the users object. So guys, by calling the get, okay, so guys by calling the getter method we can get the name, email, and the country. All right, and guys after that I am calling the execute update method. So guys here you can see that I am calling an execute update, and guys to select all the user I am calling an execute query method, and guys here I am calling an execute update, and guys if this returns is greater than 0, then guys I am making the row updated equals to, So guys, here guys, if guys it is going to greater than 0, then guys it is going to return true. So guys, I am storing in a row updated variable, and guys I am returning the row updated values as a true or a false. Okay, so guys I have implemented the updated user method also. And now the next method and the last method of the CRUD operation is the delete method. So let's implement the delete method also. Public boolean delete user. Okay, and guys I will delete the user according to our ID. All right, so guys let me write the code and the implementation, then I will explain you. So guys, I have implemented the delete users method, in which I will delete any user according to ID. So I have passed ID in an argument, and I have created a variable with the name do row deleted of a type boolean. And first step is to get connection, and then the second step is to create the prepared statement of by using the connection object. And here I am passing the delete user as well. So guys, you can see that we have delete from users table where ID is something. Okay, so guys, after that I am setting the ID by calling a statement dot set in it. And then guys, I am calling execute update method to execute the query. Okay, and now guys, if this is greater than 0, then it means that row deleted will be true. All right, and after that guys, it is going to return the row deleted as a true or false. All right, so guys, still here I have implemented all the CRUDs method in our DAO class. And the CRUD method like to insert any user, to select any user according to ID, and to select all the users. Okay, and also a method to update any user according to the user. Okay, and then we have a delete user according to its ID. All right, so guys, I have completed the user DAO class. And now guys, the next step, we have to create a servlet. All right, so let's go to our web package. And guys, inside the web package I am going to create a new servlet. So new, and guys you have to click on the servlet and not on the class. All right, so servlet, and then guys here you have to provide the servlet name. So let's say that I am keeping the servlet name as a user servlet, user servlet, user servlet. Yeah, spelling is perfect. So let's do it next. And guys, here you can see that we are getting a user mapping as user servlet. So next, and then do get, do post. And guys, I want to create init method also. All right, so guys, these are the three method I want to generate inside my servlet class, and then finish it. So guys, here you can see that I have successfully created the user servlet class. And guys, here you can see that at the rate web servlet annotation we have a slash user servlet. So guys here can be a different type of actions. And guys, the actions can be like to create, to insert user, to edit user, to delete user, and so on. All right, so guys, let's create a switch case to handle all the actions. Okay, so guys first of all guys, I am going to define the URL. So guys here I am going to remove this. And guys, here guys I will handle all the request with a single servlet only. So that's why I will remove this user servlet, and I will keep a black slash here. So guys, here it will call all the time the same servlet. It means the user servlet. Okay, so guys here I am using a single servlet to handle all the request. All right, so let me clean this code for now. We have so remove this, we don't required for this project. So we have an init method, that's fine. So remove the argument. Okay, and we have a do get method, and we have a do post method. All right, so let me bring this to get do post method above our do get method. All right, so we have a do post method, and guys, inside the do post method we are calling the do get method. All right, And guys, inside the doGet method, I am going to write all the methods, means all the implementation to handle all the actions. Okay. So guys, inside the doGet method, I will handle all the actions. And guys, the actions can be, as I told you, like it can be create, insert, edit, delete, and so on. Okay. So guys, for that I will create a switch statement. So guys, let's create switch statement. So for that, guys, first take an action from the string action, from the request we have to take the action equals to get servlet path. All right. So guys, we are taking the action from the request method by calling a get servlet method from the request object. Okay, and we are storing in an action variable. And now guys, I will write a switch case to handle all the actions. So guys, pass this variable action here, and inside the switch case, let's create a different cases slash new. All right. Let's create a break. All right. So guys, let's copy this case. Let's paste it here and let's change the action as an insert. All right. All right. Let's put another case like new insert, and the next let's keep it as a delete. All right. And after that, let's put a case with the action edit. So guys, all these actions we are checking in our case statement. So next I will check as an update. Okay. So we have a edit action, we have update action. And now guys, we have the last as a default. So guys, we have a default statement also. FAULT, all right. And let's put a break statement. So guys, we have a default statement, and guys, we have the actions like a new, insert, delete, edit, and update. And guys, if there is an action remaining than this, then guys, it will go to the default section. Okay. So guys, if the action is new, then guys, I have to call a method. So let me create a method for this. So this is our for the switch. And this is for the doGet method. All right. So let me create a method, a separate method. If a new action is provided, then guys, I am going to create a method with the name showNewForm. Okay. So guys, I am going to create a showNewForm. So private void showNewForm. Okay. And inside this method, guys, we have to pass the request and response as an argument also. So no worry guys, let me write the code first and then I will explain you. So guys, I have written the showNewForm method. So let me minimize this and let me explain you. So guys, if the action is like a new, then guys, it is going to call the showNewForm method. Okay. And inside this, we have to pass the request and the response object of the HTTP servlet. All right. So guys, it is going to call the showNewForm method. And guys, inside this, we have an argument as request and response. And guys, it is going to transfer the JSP to the user form JSP. Okay. So guys, we are here we are using a request dispatcher to forward to our JSP page as a user form JSP page. Okay. So let me import this to the Java X servlet. All right. And guys, here I am doing a dispatcher.forward to forward the request to our user form.jsp. And guys, here I am going to create a user form.jsp later in this okay lecture. So so guys, if there is any action with a new, then guys it is going to transfer to the JSP like user form.jsp. And guys, inside the user form JSP, I will assign the form values like a name, email and a country to insert the values, and to click a save button to insert the user data to the database. Already, all right. So guys, I have created, or guys, I have written a method like show new form to handle the new action. And now guys, the next action can be like a insert action. So guys, to insert action, I will create a separate method. So let's say that so let's go here, and guys, here you can see that we are getting an syntax. Okay, so guys, here I'm missing one curly braces, close curly braces. Yeah, now it's fine. So let's create a method, separate method to handle the insert action. Okay, so private void insert user. All right. So guys, let me write the code first and then I will explain you. Yes guys, so let me define this as a insert user. Okay, and guys, in this we have the two argument as a request and the response. And guys, here we have to throw, so we have to import with a java.sql. okay, and guys, in this guys, I am taking the name and the email and the country by the help of the request object. And guys, by calling the get parameter method of the request object, we are taking the name. And guys, I am taking the name from the form JSP page which we are going to enter to create or to insert a new data. So guys, here I will provide a name and the email and the country. So guys, we are taking that values to our servlet method by the help of the request object. And guys, we have a get parameter method to take the values of the JSP like name, email, country, and we are storing in a variable name, email, country. And guys, after that I am storing it in a user bean class by creating the object and passing in a constructor of that. And guys, here is the new user object. And guys, it contains the all the name and email and the country. And then guys, I am calling the insert method, user DAO insert method, to call the insert method. So guys, I have to create the object of the DAO here. So first of all, let's define, declare the user DAO. Okay, with the user DAO. All right, so we have to import this from a DAO package. All right, and guys, inside the init method, I am going to run the user DAO equals to new user DAO class constructor. And then guys, I am going to call the insert user method of the DAO class to insert this user to our database. Okay, and guys, here I am sending a response as a send direct. So guys, it is going to take the action as a list. And guys, here you can see that we have actions like name, insert, delete, edit, update. And guys, here the list is different, so guys, it will handle by the default section of the switch statement. And guys, which we are going to implement further later. Okay, so guys, still here guys, I have written and I have implemented the insert user method in servlet to handle the insert action to insert any data, user data, to the database. All right. And guys, here I am storing to the user and then we are calling insert user. All right, so next, so guys, I have to call this insert user to the, so let's call this pass request and response. All right, all right. So next guys, what we have to do, So guys, the next we have to handle the delete action. Okay, so guys, to handle the delete action, we can create a separate method. So let's create a separate method to handle the delete. So delete user, alright. So let's create a private method, private void, and the delete user method. Alright, so guys, let me implement this code and then I will explain you. Yes guys, so in this, the delete user, we have a two argument as a request and response. And guys, I am taking the ID from the request object by calling the get parameter, and guys, I am transferring into the integer type and storing in an ID variable. Okay, and guys, with this I am calling the delete user method of the DAO class directly, like user DAO dot delete user. And guys, inside this I am passing the ID to delete the user according to this ID. Okay, and guys, it will delete the user by running the query to the database. All right, so guys, and after that guys, I am returning the response dot send direct to the list. So guys, it will handle by the switch case of the default section. Okay, so guys, still here I have completed the delete user method also. So let's copy this method and call this from the delete action, and here we have to pass the request and the response. All right, so guys, still here we have handle the delete action also. And now guys, the next we have to handle is the edit, is to the handle the edit. So guys, here guys, we have to create a separate method, so for the handle the edit action. So let's go beneath this edit. Okay, so let's create a separate method, private void, so edit form. All right, so guys, let me write the code of this method and then I will explain you. So guys, inside the so edit form method, we have the two argument as a request and response, and then guys, we are taking the ID from the request object by calling the get parameter method. And then we are converting into the integer and storing in an ID. And then guys, I have created the user existing user object or the reference variable. And then guys, I am calling the select user method. So guys, it is going to fetch the user object according to this ID. And guys, it is going to return here. And guys, we are storing it in an existing user. And now guys, here I am using the request parameter, the request dispatcher, to forward the request to the GSP page, the user form GSP page, which we are going to create in a later part of this video. Okay, and guys, here I am setting the existing user method to the user key. And guys, here I am using the set attribute method of the request object to set the existing user object to the user key. And guys, here I am guys, after that, in the future, in guys, in the GSP page, I am going to use this key to get the existing user and to write in a table. Okay, so guys, after that I am using a dispatcher.forward method to forward the request to the user form.gsp page. All right, and guys, here the return type is void. All right, so till here I have handled the edit action also. So let's call this method from the switch part and let's pass the request and response. All right, so guys, the next I have to handle is the update action. So guys, for that I will create a separate method to handle the update action. Okay, so let's create update. All right, private void update user. All right, so let me write the code and then I will explain you. So guys, I have written the update user implementation, and guys, in the same way I am taking the ID And then after that, I am taking the name, email, and the country from the GSP page by using the request method and by calling the get parameter method of the request object. All right, name, email, and the country will be storing in a name email variable, and then I am passing it and storing in a user bin, and then I am calling an update user method to update that object or the user object to the database. So guys, here the update user method is called to the DAO class, and guys, it is going to pass the user, and guys, it is going to update that user, all right, by calling the query update users SQL, all right. And then guys, here I am sending a response dot send redirect to the list, and guys, it will handle by the default section of the switch case, all right. So guys, till here I have updated the user, and now guys, let me call this method from the update section, all right. So request slash response, all right. So now guys, the next section we have to handle is a default section, and guys, if the actions are other than the new, insert, delete, edit, or update, then guys, it will be handled by the default section. So let me create a separate method to handle the default section. So this is for the default section. All right. So guys, let me create a separate method to handle this also. So private void list user. So let's say that this will be showing the list of all the users. So guys, let me write this code and I will explain you. So guys, I have written the list user method, and guys, here you can see that I am calling the select all user method for from the user DAO, and guys, it is going to return all the users in a list. So guys, I'm storing in a list, okay. So let's import this to a Java util package, and guys, here the list user will contain all the users object present inside our database, and after that guys, I am setting the list user to the list users key by using the set attribute method of the request object, so that I can use this key in our GSP page to list out all the users, okay. And guys, after that I am taking a request dispatcher to forward my request to the user list.jsp page, all right. So guys, still here I have created, and guys, I have handled all the actions. So let me call this from the default section. Okay, and guys, here we have to pass the request and the response. All right. So guys, still here I have handled the switch case for all the actions like new, insert, delete, edit, update. And guys, if there is any action, and guys, here you can see that we have action like list, and guys, downward you can see we have a list. So guys, it will be handled by the default section of the switch. So guys, it is going to call the list user, and guys, it is going to fetch all the users, and guys, it is going to store in a user list key, and then it will show our user list GSP. It means that guys, inside the user list GSP I will use this key, and guys, I will iterate the values present inside the list user, and then guys, I will show that users in a form of table to display all the IDs and the names and the countries and the emails which are present in each user object, all right. So guys, still here we have created our servlet class, we have a DAO class, and we have a user bin class. So guys, our next step is to create like a GSP page, all right. So guys, let's create first of all the error.jsp page. So right click on the web content GSP, and then guys, here we can create our error page to display the error if we face any error. Error error.jsp, then finish it. So guys, inside So guys, here let's insert title here. So let's make it as a error. All right. And inside the body, let's put center tag to show the error in a center. All right. And then guys, I will using a header one tag to show the error. All right. And the header two tag to show. So guys, here I will use and then equals to exception object, and guys we have a get message to the exception object. Get message, message, message. So, and guys here it is a like exception is an object of the error page. So guys, we have to make this and show this that guys, this is an error page. So we have to use a tag like is error page, all right, equals to true. All right, so it is showing an error. Is error page. So let me save this. Okay. I have done some mistake here. So actually, I have to write this before this percentage tag. Okay. Now I think it's fine. It should work. Save this. Yeah, so guys, I have created the error.jsp to show the error which we will get. Okay, and now guys, the next JSP we will create. So let's save all the pages. Why we are getting an error? Okay, we have extra curly braces closed, I think. So this is, yeah, now it's fine. Okay, so guys, the next I am going to create a JSP for the user list JSP. Okay, so let's go to the web content, new and JSP, and guys, here I am creating the name with the name user list JSP to show all the list of the user. Okay, so guys, here I am going to write this code. So guys, I'm going to pause this video, and guys, I'm going to write the JSP page, and then guys, I will explain you all the code one by one. Okay, and guys, it will save some time for us. All right, so let me write the code for the user list JSP. And guys, I have written the user list dot JSP, and guys, you can see that I'm using the title as a user management application. All right, and guys, here I am using a CDN to get the bootstrap mean.css file, or guys, you can store this mean the bootstrap.mean.css file, the code inside a file, and then guys, you can import this in this JSP page. Okay, so guys, here I'm using a CDN format. All right, and guys, after that, guys, here I will use a bootstrap for to design our page. And guys, here let's see that we have a header tag, and inside the header I'm using a navbar, and guys, it is a class of a bootstrap. And guys, here you can see I'm using a background color is blue, and we have hreference as our website name as www.xadmin.net. And guys, here I'm showing a management application, user management application, and then guys, I'm taking the request dot the get context path, and guys, here it is slash list. So guys, if I will click the user list, then guys, it is going to throw the action as a list, and guys, it is going to capture by the user servlet. And guys, here you can see that we have a, so now we are getting some error on handle. Okay, so we have to surround it with a try and catch. No problem, let me handle this first, and then I will explain you the code. Surround with try and catch. डन, यस यस गाइस, ऑल डन। लेट मी सेव दिस। सो गाइज, इनसाइड द यूजर लिस्ट यू कैन सी दैट वी हैव अ रिक्वेस्ट डॉट गेट कॉन्टेक्स्ट पाथ एंड वी हैव अ लिस्ट पाथ। सो गाइज, इट विल बी कैप्चर्ड बाय द यूजर सर्वलेट एंड गाइज हेयर यू कैन सी दैट एंड गाइज हेयर यू कैन सी दैट वी हैव अ लिस्ट ऑफ एक्शंस एंड वी हैव अ केसेस। सो गाइज द लिस्ट एंड गाइज हेयर द लिस्ट एक्शन विल गो टू द डिफॉल्ट पाथ एंड गाइज हेयर द डिफॉल्ट सेक्शन इज कॉलिंग द लिस्ट यूजर मैथड्स। सो गाइज इट विल कॉल द लिस्ट यूजर मैथड एंड गाइज इट विल टेक ऑल द लिस्ट ऑफ द यूजर फ्रॉम द डेटा बेस एंड गाइज इट इज गोइंग टू डिस्प्ले एंड गाइज हेयर यू कैन से दैट आई एम यूजिंग अ लिस्ट यूजर एंड गाइज आई एम सेविंग द लिस्ट यूजर मीन्स द ऑल यूजर लिस्ट टू द लिस्ट यूजर्स की एंड गाइज इफ यू विल सी इन द यूजर लिस्ट, ओके एंड गाइज इन द यूजर लिस्ट आई हैव मेड अ टेबल एंड गाइज इन साइड द टेबल यू कैन सी दैट आई एम यूजिंग दिस की विच आई हैव सेव्ड इन द लिस्ट यूजर मैथड एज अ लिस्ट यूजर की एंड गाइज यू कैन सी दैट आई एम यूजिंग दिस की टू गेट द लिस्ट ऑफ द ऑल यूजर एंड देन आई एम यूजिंग एंड देन गाइज आई एम शोइंग द यूजर डॉट आई डी इन अ टेबल यूजर डॉट नेम एंड द यूजर डॉट ई मेल यूजर डॉट कंट्री एंड दैट गाइज इन साइड द एक्शन कॉलम आई एम शोइंग द टू बटन्स लाइक द एडिट एंड द डिलीट बटन। ऑल राइट, सो गाइज दिस इज द जी एस पी पेज एंड गाइज इफ यू विल सी इफ आई विल क्लिक द एडिट देन गाइज इट इज गोइंग टू पास लाइक द एडिट एंड द आई डी वैल्यू। ओके, सो गाइज इट इज गोइंग टू पास द एक्शन एज एडिट एंड गाइज इफ आई विल क्लिक ऑन द डिलीट देन गाइज इट इज गोइंग टू पास द एक्शन एज अ डिलीट एंड गाइज इट विल कैप्चर बाय आवर सर्वलेट यूजर सर्वलेट एंड गाइज इट विल कैप्चर बाई यूजर सर्वलेट एंड हेयर यू कैन सी दैट वी आर गेटिंग अ केस एज अ डिलीट एंड एडिट एंड गाइज इट इज गोइंग टू कॉल द डिलीट यूजर एंड गाइज इट इज गोइंग टू कॉल द मैथड एंड गाइज इट इज गोइंग टू कॉल द डाउ क्लास डिलीट एंड गाइज इट इज गोइंग टू डिलीट द यूजर फ्रॉम द डेटा बेस। ऑल राइट, सो गाइज दिस इज द यूजर लिस्ट। ओके एंड नाउ गाइज द नेक्स्ट जी एस पी आई हैव टू क्रिएट, लेट मी चेक, या it is the user form JSP. okay, so guys the user form JSP is basically a form to create a new user. all right, so let me click web content then generate JSP file, let's paste this user form.jsp. all right, then do it finish. So guys, let me write the code for the user form.jsp and then I will explain you. So guys, I have written the user form.jsp and guys, you can see that we have a title as a user management application and guys, in the same way, I am using the CDN for the bootstrap min.css. Okay, and guys, here we have a header. And we have a user management application and guys here we have a list. After guys, if I will click on the user then okay, then guys it is going to show the user list and then guys we have the two option like the update and the insert and guys inside this you can see that inside the card body I have written if the user is not null then guys it is going to take the action as update and the method as a post. So guys here the method is post, so guys it is going to call the servlet do post method and guys here you can see that we have insert action, so guys it is going to call the do post method but with the insert. Okay, and now guys here you can see if the user is not null then it is edit user and if the user is null it means that we have to add a new user, so guys it will show add new user. All right, and guys I have created the form here to save the new user. Like if the user is not null, then guys it is going to show this form like the form group. I have used the class of the bootstrap to design our form for the username and for the email and also for the user country and then we have a submit button to save. Okay, and then guys inside this you can see we have a user.name, user.email and user.country will display the values also. All right, and guys here we are using a form control class of the bootstrap to design our form. All right, so guys in this way guys I have created the user form JSP page also. And guy okay and okay and guys, I will share my the GitHub repository URL so that guys you can paste the JSP and guys you can study the JSP, okay, from there. So till here guys, I have created the error page, user list and the user form and servlet and the DAO and the user bean class. Now guys, the next step, and guys let's see that I have also pasted the lib folder, okay, all the libraries and the jars. So guys, the next step is to write the code to the web.xml. So guys, here inside the web.xml I'm going to write the code. So guys, inside the web.xml we have a welcome file. So let us sign the user dash list dot jsp as a welcome file. So guys, it means that as our application start, then guys it will go for the welcome file, it will find for the welcome file. So guys, here you will see that user list is defined. So guys, it will display our user list dot jsp as a welcome file. And now guys, inside this I will, after this welcome file, I will define an error tag to handle our all the errors, okay. So error page, all right. And inside the error page page tag, I will define the exception type. So let's say exception type. So let's keep the java dot lang dot exception, okay. And after this guys, I will use a location. So location is my error dot jsp page, and guys here is my jsp page, okay. So guys, it is going to show our error dot jsp page if there is any exception occurs, like java dot lang dot exception. So guys, it is going to handle all the exceptions here, okay. And we have a welcome file also. So guys, still here we have done. Now guys, the next step is for me is to open the MySQL workbench, okay. So guys, this is my MySQL workbench. Let's do a login. All right. And guys, inside this you can see that we have a user DB, okay. So guys, this is my the database name as a user DB, and we have a tables. So let's see that we have a two tables already, so no problem. So let's create another table. So guys, we have used the users table in our code. If you will see in my DAO class, so guys, I have written the SQL and where I have used the user table, okay. So let's create the table with the name users, and then let's create the columns like ID, and the ID will be primary key and the auto increment ID, all right. And the second column I am going to create as a name, and the third column I am going to create as an email, and the fourth column I am going to create as a country, country, all right. So guys, these are the four columns I will create with this user table. So let me check that is that users only now. So for that, go to the DAO, go to query. Yes, we have a users. Let me check the spelling, otherwise it will not work. MySQL users, yeah, it's fine. Users, okay. So let's keep this as a not null, email not null. No problem, we can skip this. So apply. So guys, it is going to run this query as a create table with the name users in the user DB. So ID, name, email, country, and primary key is ID, and the ID is also auto increment ID, okay. So let's apply. So guys, here you can see that I have created the users table. So let's call this, and guys, you can see that we have a columns like ID, name, email, country, and we don't have any data till now, okay. So guys, inside our database, I have created a table with the name users, and I have a column with the name ID, name, email, and country. All right. So this I have done. So our next step is to like, guys, we have to deploy this our project inside our. Okay. So for that, guys, we have to right click on the project, and we have to build path and the configure build path. And then, guys, we have to go to the server, and guys, you have to select the Tomcat 8.5 server at localhost. Okay, and guys, then you have to apply. And guys, here already it is selected, so no problem. So click on OK, and then we have to run this on our server. So run as Rarum server. So guys, I'm running this project on our server. So let's see that it is working. Yes, guys, it's worked, and we got our display like the welcome page. So let's copy this and let's go to our Chrome and let me paste it here. And guys, you can see that this is my the welcome page and this is the list. So guys, here so there is some error it is showing. Okay. There is a problem, class not found JDBC driver. So let me check my code first. DAO. Okay, guys, here I have written a string for the JDBC driver. So I have to remove this string because, guys, already I have defined a variable here now. So for that I have to pass this variable so that it will take a com.mysql JDBC driver. All right. So now it's fine. So let's save this. It was a very minor mistake, guys. No problem. So let's run on server again. Yeah, restart my server. Okay. So let's go to our browser. We have already written. So refresh this file. So guys, now you can see that user list is showing nothing here. Let's add some user. So let's add like Ashish. Okay, let's add Ashish and let's keep it India as a country. So let's save it. And guys, you can see that we are able to save the data successfully. So let's go to our MySQL workbench so that we can confirm that we have entered in the database. Okay, and guys, it is showing to the database from the database. So click on this and guys, you can see that we have a name, email, and the country here entering our database already. Okay, so let's go to the Chrome. So let's add some more user. So let's add Gurpreet @gmail.com. Let's keep this as a Spain country and save it. So let's add one more user with the name xadmin.gmail. Let's keep this as a USA. Okay, and let's save it. So guys, we are able to save a new user. And now guys, let's check that whether we are edit or not. So guys, you can see that we are able to open the edit form page, and inside this, let's say Ashish updated and the updated and the country love India. Okay, so let's say love India. Let's save it. So guys, you can see that I am able to update my Ashish to the Ashish updated and the URL with the Ashish 2012 updated and the country as a love country. And now guys, we are going to check the delete method. So let's delete the xadmin first. So yes guys, we can able to see that we are able to delete the xadmin, we are able to delete the Gurpreet also. All right, so let's go to our MySQL workbench. Let's click and guys, here you can see that we are able to delete all the others two items users, and now guys, I am left with the user updated. Okay, and guys, this is a small project. So guys, this is for the user list, so for showing the user list. Okay. And guys, this is a small project to show you how to write a CRUD operations, like to insert a data in the database to get all the object from the database to get any particular data according to the ID from the database, and also to edit the data and to delete the object from the database by using the Servlet JSP and the JDBC, okay, and also with the Tomcat server. So guys, okay, so guys, for this I have used the three classes, like the bean class as a user bean class, and the DAO class, and also a servlet class, and I have used the JSP pages. And guys, the JSP pages is sending the action, and guys, it is going to the user servlet, and guys, it is going to take the action by the request.getServletPath, and guys, it is going to check the switch case. If the action is the new, then guys, it is going to show new form. And guys, if the action is like insert, then guys, it is going to call the insert method. And guys, inside the insert method, this is going to call the DAO insert method. And after that, guys, it is running the query, insert query, to insert the user object to the database. In the same way, guys, if the action is delete, then guys, it is going to delete the user object from the database. In the same way, it is going to edit and update. Okay, so guys, this is a very small user management project to show you how to write the CRUD operations. Okay, so guys, thank you and have a nice day, and see you in the next lecture. Thank you.